Hello friends, welcome to another lecture of CAD-CAM CAE lecture series. Today we are going to see a CAND cycle program for the drilling operation. CAND cycle program for the drilling operation. So as you can see, this is the part, okay, which has two holes to be drilled. Okay, the plate is of the dimension 70 mm by 70 mm. Okay, the hole locations are at 10, 10 and 60, 60. Okay, and the diameter of both the holes is 10 millimeters, and the plate thickness given is also 10 millimeters, and both the holes are through holes. Okay, so for this we are going to use the 10 millimeter HSS drill, high speed steel drill, and it is required to carry out this operation with the help of CAND cycle. Okay, with the help of CAND cycle. So when it comes to the CAND cycle mode, we have already seen that CAND cycle is used wherever we have repeated motion. Okay, wherever we have repeated motion. So in repeated motion, what happens? The tool is going to do a repeated activity, just like it is going to reach to this place. Okay, then it is going to go down. Okay, complete the drill and come up. Okay, so go down, complete the drilling and come up. This is a repetitive motion, and this repetitive motion has to be carried out at different locations. Okay, at different coordinate locations. So this is first coordinate location, this is the second coordinate location, and such type of activity is required when we have to drill, let's say, pattern holes. So if on a particular, say, workpiece or a plate, okay, if you require to drill number of holes which are following certain pattern, okay, which are following certain pattern, then we don't go on writing the individual code for each hole, because that would be very tiresome and very lengthy work. But instead, what we do is we use CAND cycle mode of the CNC machine. So CAND cycle modes are very effective when you want to drill many holes on plate, and that too with repeated accuracy. And CAND cycle mode, when you are trying to write a manual part program, at that time also CAND cycle mode is effective in reducing the number of lines of codes that you are going to write, and it is very convenient to cover all the holes, okay, which are set in a particular pattern, and there we effectively make use of the, let's say, absolute positioning system is a by default system which we normally use. But when it's a matter of, let's say, CAND cycle mode, okay, CAND cycle mode, then we very often use a incremental positioning system if we have a certain pattern to trace, okay, certain pattern to trace. So here we'll not be using incremental mode, because we just will be demonstrating the how to declare CAND cycle in a program, okay, how to write coordinates, okay, and how exactly CAND cycle works, okay, how exactly CAND cycle works. So like the last time, okay, the tool is far away at its home position, let's say at x equal to 200, y equal to 200, z equal to 100. Okay, so it is far away. Okay, from there the tool approaches the first location. Okay, tool approaches the first location, it completes the drilling. Okay, then again it comes up. Okay, then it goes to the next location, it completes the drilling, it goes up. Okay, and again it is being taken back to its home position. So when it is at its home position, okay, we perform the tool change operation initially. Okay, then we install the drilling tool. Okay, then it comes to this location, comes to the initial level. Okay, comes to the initial level. Then we switch on the spindle, we switch on the coolant supply. Okay, then the drilling is performed. Okay, it comes back to the reference level. Okay, it comes back to the reference level. From that reference level, it goes to this location, and during that travel, okay, even though it's a rapid travel, okay, but we keep the spindle on and coolant on. Okay, we keep the spindle on and coolant on. We can switch off the coolant and spindle depending on the requirement. Okay, but generally to avoid elapsed times, okay, we tend to keep that on, because these drilling operations can happen very rapidly. okay, drilling operations can happen very rapidly, and the plate thickness is also not much, okay, so it doesn't take that much time. So before the first drilling, okay, we bring the tool at a reference level. We switch on the spindle, okay, here we are switching on the spindle clockwise direction. Then we switch on the flood type coolant using M07, okay, and as we complete the drill, the tool comes back to the reference level, okay. From that reference level, rapidly the tool is taken to the next location, okay, without changing the Z reference level, okay, without changing the Z reference level, okay. Again, the tool is already, the machine is already in Cant cycle mode. So as soon as it gets the next coordinate, okay, as soon as it gets the next coordinate, it goes to the next coordinate location and performs the repeated motion, that is going down, okay, performing the drilling, coming up in a rapid mode, okay. So all that setting and the program we will just see. So this is the program with Cant cycle. So as we all know, the program starts with the percent sign, and program ends with a percent sign, okay. So percent MPF, that is main program file 1235, you can have the program number written over here, okay. Then I have some additional information which is being used in this program. So it is a drilling operation with cutter diameter 10 mm HSS drill, okay, which is being stored at and called as tool number 1. So T01 is a tool number, okay, and we are going to use a drilling Cant cycle in this program, okay. We are going to use a drilling Cant cycle in this program. So as you can see, the parenthesis ensures that this portion is not going to be executed, okay, by the machine control unit, okay. It is just for the sake of understanding, okay, of what the program is all about, okay. Then the actual program begins. So N005 G00 indicates the rapid mode, then G49 G40 G80, these are all cancellation codes, okay. As I mentioned, these are modal codes, okay. So modal codes are staying on the machine unless and until we cancel them, okay. So this is safety precaution, that every time we begin with a fresh program, we ensure that there are no instructions pending from the last operation on the machine, and we ensure that all those compensations and all those Cant cycles are cancelled, okay, and then we will begin a fresh program, okay. We will begin a fresh program. So G00 ensures a rapid mode, G49 is a tool length compensation off, then G40 tool diameter, cutter diameter compensation off, G80 is for the Cant cycle off or cancel Cant cycle, then G71 is for the metric programming, and G90 is for the absolute positioning system, and asterisk sign indicates that this is going to be the end of block, okay. This is going to be the end of block. So all the instruction details, okay, I have included as comments, okay. These are all comments. Even this the content which is included in a round parenthesis are called as comments, which will not be executed by the program, okay. So this is the explanation of this block, okay, explanation of this block. Now as far as writing of the program at any test or at any exam is concerned, okay, it is a good practice to write whatever you want to say, okay, in this line. Okay, it's a very good practice to write whatever you want to say, okay, in a comments box, and by reading your comments you will be graded, okay. By reading your comments you will be graded. So it's a very good practice always to write comments, okay. Eventually when you are going to work, okay, on the CNC simulation software, okay, at that time most probably you will have this comment, okay, which is part of program, okay, but these comments will not be there in the program that you will generate using a software like, let's say, MasterCam or DellCam, okay. So there you will not have these comments. These comments are it is understood that you understand each and every code and why that code has been placed, okay, in that block. So just to make it a habit, okay, when we are studying this, okay, it's a good practice to mention the explanation of that block, okay, after every block, like a comment, okay. So this is a comment for the first block. End of block indicates that the instructions are over in this block, the next block will be continued. So N010, the sequence number, G00, X200, Y200, Z100. This is the home position of the tool, or it is also called as set point of the tool. Okay, and the tool will be changed at this location. So home position is a place where tool change instruction can take place. So I have immediately in the next block N015, M06, T01. So I have already mentioned over here T01 is a drilling tool with 10 mm diameter. So tool change to tool number 1, T01. Okay, so this is the third block. Then once the tool is changed, okay, then in a rapid mode we take the tool to the location number 1, okay, drilling location number 1, which is 10,10. Okay, so N020, G00, X10, Y10, Z10, okay, X10, Y10, Z10. Then once the tool reaches, okay, to this location, okay, we switch on the spindle. Okay, we switch on the spindle. The spindle speed is 700 RPM. Okay, and the spindle is rotating in a clockwise direction. So S700 is a speed of spindle, and M03 ensures that spindle is going to rotate in a clockwise direction at the desired speed or at the given speed. And M07 is the coolant supply on, and the coolant supply is a flood type coolant supply. Okay, so M07 is for flood type coolant. Okay, M08 is for mist type coolant, and M09 is for the coolant supply off. Okay, similarly M03 is for the clockwise rotation of the spindle. M04 is for the counterclockwise rotation or anti-clockwise rotation of the spindle, and M05 is for the spindle off. Okay, spindle off. So then the end of the block instruction, and we move to the next block. So from this block onwards, we are switching off the canned cycle mode. Okay, we are switching on the canned cycle mode. So N025, G81 is for the canned cycle, drilling canned cycle on milling machine. Okay, drilling canned cycle on milling machine. G99 is for the return to initial level. Okay, return to initial level. Okay, X10, Y10, we again resupply the coordinates. Okay, the starting, the coordinate number 1 or the hole number 1 center coordinate, that is X10, Y10. Then Z-13 and R2. Okay, Z-13 and R2. R2 is the initial reference level which we are defining with G99. So if you are writing G99, there has to be R2. Okay, there has to be R2 statement. So G81 is for the canned cycle mode on, that is drilling canned cycle mode on milling machine or milling center or machining center. G99 ensures that, okay, the tool will come to the initial reference level, okay, after completing the drill. Okay, after completing the drill. So G81, when you are writing, you should supply a repetitive motion. Okay, repetitive motion. So Z-13. Okay, Z-13 is the same repeat motion that is going to happen, and R2. Okay, it is going to come up rapidly. Okay, it is going to come up rapidly at 2 mm above the top plane, that is Z2. So that R2 is a specific instruction used. Okay, R2 has to be taken as Z=2. Okay, Z=2. So R2 specifically we are writing because we want to ensure that the canned cycle mode operates in a way, okay, the tool is taken down where the drilling operation happens at a specific feed rate. So this feed rate F113 millimeters per or F113 millimeters per minute. Okay, this is the feed rate. Okay, so at that feed the drilling operation is going to take place. Okay, so Z-3 will be achieved at specified feed rate. Okay, and once it reaches Z-13, okay, it is going to come up rapidly. Okay, it is going to come up rapidly. The spindle will be on, but it is going to come up rapidly because already the drilling will be completed. Okay, drilling doesn't happen in a return travel. Okay, drilling only happens in a forward travel as the tool is moving in a downward direction. So as the tool is coming up, even though spindle is rotating, the drilling operation is already completed. Okay, and at what level the tool has to return? The tool has to return to initial reference level. okay, initial reference level, which is R2. R2 is a special code used. R2 means Z equal to 2. So 2 mm above the top plane. Okay, 2 mm above the top plane. Okay, so Cannes cycle mode is already on and we have instructed the tool. Once you complete the drilling, okay, come back to the initial reference level. Okay, and the Cannes cycle feed, okay, the feed with which the drilling is taking place is also mentioned. Okay, is also mentioned. So that's what I have written over here. Drilling Cannes cycle on, return to initial level Z equal to 2 mm with feed rate specified. Okay, with feed rate specified is for the drilling operation. So drilling Cannes cycle mode on, okay, with feed rate specified, and return to initial level Z equal to 2 mm. Okay, that would be the proper way of writing. Okay, and then the next line, what we are going to specify once the machine is in Cannes cycle mode is, okay, we are only going to specify the change in coordinates. Okay, we are only going to specify the change in coordinates. So in next line, what I specify? X60 Y60. As you can see, 10, 10 is the first drilling location, 60, 60 is the second drilling location. So my machine is already in Cannes cycle mode. I will only specify the change in coordinates. So both the coordinates are changing, so it is X60 Y60. What the tool is going to do? Tool is going to do the same thing, G81. So Z-13 at feed 113, and it is going to come up to reference level Z equal to 2 mm. So this activity will be repeated, and this is what we call as repeat motion of the tool. Okay, this is what we call as repetitive motion of the tool. Okay, so once this is done, okay, then we will switch off the Cannes cycle because we only had to drill 2 holes. Now if we have more than 2 holes to drill, what we are going to do after this? We will just keep on changing the coordinates. Okay, we will just keep on changing the coordinates. We don't have to write at what feed it has to drill, at what level it has to come up. So that saves few lines of codes. Okay, that saves few lines of codes, and the machine behaves in a proper way. Okay, machine behaves in a proper way. So that is very helpful. Okay, so the next line is N035 G80. So we are going to cancel the Cannes cycle. Okay, G98 is for the return to reference level. Okay, return to reference level. Now if you are paying attention, the reference level which we set before the Cannes cycle block was Z10. Okay, Z10. If you concentrate again over here, the second line, the home position, the Z coordinate is 100. Okay, then we brought it down to Z10. So that becomes the reference level. Okay, that becomes the reference level. And the initial level is the level at which the drilling is to be continued. Okay, drilling is to be continued. And at that level, my spindle and my coolant supply is on. Okay, my spindle and coolant supply is on. Okay, at Z equal to 10, I actually started my spindle and coolant. Okay, so as I go back to that level, okay, G98 is return to reference level. Okay, I am going to switch off the spindle and coolant. Okay, I am going to switch off the spindle and coolant. So M05 spindle off, M09 coolant supply off. Okay, then I will take my tool back to the home position or set point. So N040, that is G00, in a rapid mode, I will take my tool back to the X200, Y200, Z100. Okay, so go back to the set point at rapid mode. And the next line, M30, that is the end of program or tape rewind. Okay, and then I will have this percent sign indicating that the program has ended. So this is a very simple program. Okay, we had already seen a program without Cannes cycle, okay, in the last lecture. This is a program with Cannes cycle. Okay, in coming lectures we will see few more complex programs again based on Cannes cycles. We also have to see do loop, we also have to see macro programming. Okay, we also have to see macro programming. So that we will see in the coming lectures. So I hope you have understood a very small concept, okay, of Cannes cycle program, Cannes cycle drilling program on the milling machine center, and how it is very effective if you have let's say more than holes, okay, more than 2, 3, 4 holes have to drill. Okay, and those holes have to be drilled in a certain pattern. Okay, so there the Cant cycle is very effective, and it considerably reduces the length of the program. Okay, it considerably reduces the length of the program. So I hope you have understood this. Okay, stay tuned for more such interesting content on computer aided manufacturing. Okay, so thank you.